With the 2020 general election only 90 days away, concern is growing that states may not have the tools they need.
Offering robust voting by mail, early voting, and election day options to minimize confusion and risk are optimal, but many jurisdictions don't currently have the resources.
The stimulus bill enacted in March provided $400 million to states to spend on elections. And now lawmakers are considering even more as part of the next relief package.
It is going to take more time and some resources.
A group of Republicans recently introduced a bill that would provide another $400 million to states, money that could be used for PPE, recruiting and training poll workers, and updating the voter rolls.
This is particularly coming to light during COVID when some states are looking at blasting ballots out to their rolls, where you could have situations where these ballots are going to people who are no longer there, who shouldn't have them.
That figure is significantly less than the $3.6 billion in additional election funding that Democrats passed out of the House back in May.
The amount of funding has to be commensurate with the threat. And now we're not only dealing with a foreign threat and foreign adversaries trying to interfere in our elections, but we're also dealing with a public health threat.
Democrats are pushing to expand mail-in and early voting during the pandemic. This has become a major point of contention with the White House after the president suggested mail-in voting would lead to widespread fraud. Election experts say that is rare, but it is now contributing to a stimulus stalemate on Capitol Hill.
If there's one area that we should have bipartisan agreement on, that should be the area of protecting our democracy.
In Washington, Samantha-Jo Roth, Spectrum News.